Hi and welcome to this video. My name is Dennis and I am from Hooked on Wood. In this video I want to compare the Inca Masterlift with the Triton router. And when you want to use the Inca Masterlift for your router table, you also need a router. And in Europe we do not have that much choice, so I ended up with an AEG router. And this combination costs around $850. The Triton router has a built-in lift. And you only need this top plate that you can buy or make yourself. I purchased this Inca top plate and this combination costs around $350. Most router tables have a dust extraction in the fans, and although this is adequate when you mill an edge, if you use it without a fence, it gives a lot of mess. And if you want to make a deal with your router table, you will probably end up doing it with your table saw the next time because it's very messy. To increase the work you can do with your router, you need a good dust extraction from the underside of your table. And the best way to do this is to create an airtight box under your router table. You can do a lot more work with your router table cleanly and healthily when you put your dust extraction to this box. Box jointing, dados, dovetails, working without a fence, with a copy bit and cleaning up edges. All this you can do without much dust and mess. For me that was the game changer. If you want to make such a box, remember to do this with a sliding door. Because when your wood covers all the holes, it sucks to the air inlets pretty heavy. And in these cases you will want to open the door a bit, which can release the pressure and you can smoothly run the root through your router. If you want to know more about it, you'll find free plans for this box with all the dimensions on my website www.hookedonwood.online. When you start to work more and more with your router table, the easiest way to set up your router is from above the table. And for this, we need a router lift. So let's compare these two. The Triton router you can lift from above the table, and I believe Triton is the only brand that has this possibility. It's a very nice feature. You only need to attach it to a mounting plate and put it in your router table. And when you are on a budget, you also can make this mounting plate yourself. I choose for an Inca mounting plate, and Inca has a mounting plate specially designed for the Triton router, which means that the screws are pre-drilled at the right spot, although you still have to drill the hole for your height window. The Inca mounting plate for the Triton and the Masterlift have the same size and functions. So if you want to upgrade to a Masterlift later, you do not need to change your router table. You just put the Masterlift in it and you are good to go. If you take a closer look at the mounting plate, you can align them very nicely at 10 different points. And the main reason I choose Inca is this magnet lock system. It is very flat, strong, and you also can easily align these inserts. You can change these magnet lock inlets for the so-called clean sweep inlets that should give you even better dust extraction combined with a closed box at the underside. A set of these clean sweep inlets costs around 60 euros extra. So let's see how effective these clean sweep inlets are and if they are worth the extra money. When we use a router with the fans, there's no noticeable difference between the standard inlets you also see with other brands and the Inca clean sweep inlets. The dust extraction is perfect and the same as when you use the fans dust extraction. So you can ask yourself if you need dust extraction from your fans if you have a proper dust extraction from below the router table. When we make a dado, there is a difference. The clean sweep performs here better. In both cases, it's a significant improvement over a fence extraction that won't work with these dados. When we use a router without a fence, the clean sweep also performs better than the standard solution in this area. And both give a big improvement over no dust extraction because a fence dust extraction will not work in these cases. So the most significant benefit is to put the dust extraction under your router table in a closed box. And when you use the clean sweep inlets, your dust extraction is even more effective. So you would say that for dust extraction, these two systems perform the same, but that is not totally true. And the reason is that the Inca has a more aerodynamic shape. And I like its design very much. They put the air vents at the site, and that reduces the intake of dust into the motor. And I cannot say that it is a significant difference, but I noticed that with the Triton, the inside of my box stays a bit cleaner. The most significant difference you would expect when lifting the router. And this is the area the Masterlift really shines. Raising the router goes very smoothly and easily with the Inca Masterlift. It feels solid. There is no doubt that you work with a high quality product. If you look at the Triton, it can be a little bit more difficult to add the window in its place at the beginning. Because of the construction and lack of bearings to guide the window in its place, it is a bit more unstable. And because of that, it feels like it runs less smoothly than the Masterlift, but that's not the case. It just runs a bit less smoothly, but it is more unstable because of the construction. That said, if you look at the Triton, you see that the dust cannot reach the lifting mechanism. And in all the time I used it, it runs constantly. Sometimes I cleaned these guides, but it keeps running relatively smoothly. Dust has more effect on the smoothness of the Masterlift. And if you work with material like MDF or hardwood that can be a bit sticky, you have to clean this mechanism more often. Because when the dust is stuck to it, it doesn't run that smoothly anymore. When we want to set up the height of the router bit, the smoothness of the Masterlift is noticeable. You see the height gauge moving at 0.01 millimeter steps, and with the Triton this is a bit rougher. That said, you can perfectly adjust it at any height you want. The Masterlift has this locking mechanism at the upper side of the table, so you can use it almost all the time above the table. What surprised me a little bit is that when you adjust the height of your router bit and you want to clamp it in place, it shifts almost 0.1 millimeter. And with the Triton, it almost not shift at all when you clamp it a bit carefully. A deviation of 0.06 to 0.08 millimeter is not something you should worry about. For clamping the Triton, you need to get to the underside of your table. And I read on some forums that people do not like that. And I have to say that I did not find any difficulties with this. It goes very fast and you hardly notice you're doing it when you use it more often. I also read on some forums that users say that you do not have to clamp it. But after using it and unclamping it, you see the router bit fall. So in my opinion, you always should clamp it. And I learned it the hard way. When you clamp it, the bit stays perfectly in its place. And that same counts for the Masterlift. The Masterlift goes up and down 20 millimeter on every turn. And it is pretty precise. And although you can use a dial for it, I prefer my height gauge to measure the height of the bit. Before we continue with the comparison, I want to give you a quick look at my workbench that I can turn around into a high-end router table in just 15 seconds. And if you want to know more about this workbench, you can find a video on my channel in which I show you how flexible and multifunctional this workbench is. I'm building a new and slightly upgraded version of this workbench at this moment, and I will upload a video about building it in a few weeks. So if you do not want to miss it, subscribe to my channel. Meanwhile, I decided to upload the plans already, and you can download them on my website. These are pre-plans and not ready in every detail, but it will give you an idea how I will make this workbench. Visit www.hookedonwood.online. Changing the router bit goes a little bit different, but in both cases very easy. When you want to lift the router at its maximum position and change the bit, you have to activate a spindle lock by the Triton. For this, you need to push the off switch. And therefore, you have to go under the table again. And you do not have any difficulty to reach for this under your router table. You can blindly put the switch off and on. And now the spindle is locked. And you need only a single wrench to open it. And I like this approach because it makes it very easy to change the bit. With a Masterlift combined with an IG router, you push this knob and the spindle locks. And then you can also change it with one wrench. But you have to hold this knob in place. And I found that a bit more uncomfortable. After using both systems for some time now, what is my opinion? I think the Triton router with the Inca top plate is a fantastic combination. It has not the high-end look and feel of the Master Lift. But for around 350 euros, you have a perfect router lift and router. There are more mounting plates on the market that are more affordable, but I think that the Inca mounting plates lift the quality of this combination and makes it such a nice product for the price. I have the 1400 watt version, and that is strong enough in my opinion. I like its design, and it did not disturb me at all to reach under my router table now and then, because you can use it blindly and it's not that hard to do. I think most of us would be very happy with this solution. The Inca Master Lift is a very, very high quality product. The mounting plates is from a higher quality than I use with the Triton router. It runs very smoothly and makes the use of a router table almost perfect. It costs more than twice the price of the Triton combination, but you can see and feel the difference when you use it. It is an expensive combination, but for what you get, it seems like a reasonable price. And also the AEG, I think, is of a higher quality as a router than the Triton router. The Inca Master Lift is the same as the Jessam Master Lift. In fact, this machine is made by Jessam. The Jessam is a bit more affordable. The only difference is this Magna Lock system and these clean sweep inserts. I have to say that this system is what made me buy the Inca, and I do not regret it. I really like the magnet lock system, and I think the clean sweep system is very effective, and are one of the reasons I use my router table so much. It's a real pleasure to work with this combination, and unfortunately that comes at a price, as it mostly does. To be short, I do not think you can go wrong with either of the systems, and although I'm excited about what Triton and Inca combination offers for the price, the Inca Master Lift is of a much higher quality and it's built to use for a lifetime. So that was my comparison. I hope you liked it and that it gave you some information about the difference between these products. Thank you for watching. Stay safe, and well, we see each other next time.